I am fully convinced that even people who don't play GTA 5 are familiar with those loading screens. And since I make tutorials for live streamers, I wondered, could I make something even remotely similar to this live? That's exactly what we're going to be attempting today. Anyways, let's get right into it. All right, here we are in OBS Studio, and there's a couple of things that we need to achieve in order to get closer to that look. First things first, we're gonna need a different background, which means that we need to cut me from my original background. And for that, we're gonna use a background removal plugin for OBS Studio. Now you have to know that if you're not using a green screen, chroma key, it's never gonna be perfect. So let's add that effect to my camera. We're gonna right click on it, go to filters, and then select background removal. All right, it's not doing too well when it comes to the microphone, but everything else is pretty decent. You definitely want to tweak it to your liking, but I think the jankiness is gonna make this extra funny. Oh yeah, by the way, this is gonna be like a channel point redemption on Twitch. So background removal, check. Now we need to... Now we just need to freeze frame, because those are images in the loading screen. How do I turn my live video feed into an image? By using the freeze filter plugin for OBS Studio. So now, after removing the background, I can go ahead and add an extra filter, and it's going to be the freeze filter. If I click OK here, and I do a little pose. There it is. I am frozen, unfrozen, frozen, unfrozen, frozen. But I'm getting ahead of myself, so let me remove those. And I'm gonna create a new scene for all that stuff to go into. We're gonna call it GTA 5. And I'm gonna go ahead and add my camera back. Now for me, it's easy because my camera is in its own separate scene. So you can do that. In order to not have the filters affect this whole scene source, I'm gonna put it in a group. I'm gonna call it GTA 5 cam. And now we can add filters to the group. So first filter was background removal. And second one was freeze. All right, so far looks nothing like a GTA loading screen. So we need kind of like an effect to give it that like semi-realistic drawing type. And for that, I'm gonna be using the OBS shader filter plugin by Xaldro. We're gonna go to filters, user defined shader, click okay. I'm gonna click load shader text from file, browse, and we want to find cartoon. There you go. And basically playing with the settings so that it's still like pretty visible. It's not supposed to be like a cartoon, but we still need to see like the posterization. Value steps, for example, will give you this, this, that. And then hue steps messes with the color. But that's 1, 2, 3. I actually really like 3, so we're gonna keep it there. Now we need a background. Now, if you want to, you could Google GTA 5 loading screen background and you can find like empty backgrounds and just add them. But in my case, I'm going to use PX here or Pix here to get copyright free images and then modify them to create a new background essentially. Let's try palm trees. And you want to choose one of the pictures. I'm going to go ahead and download it. And now I can bring it to OBS Studio. So I'm going to add a new image source called a GTA 5 background image, browse for it, then find it. From there, scale it, but we're gonna modify it a little bit. We can also place it behind our group. Now, the GTA loading screen animations are a little bit different each. Some of them you will see that the background is kind of skewed, or it's like basically pivoting in 3D space while the foreground is just moving left and right. Some of them, the background is just scaling down or just moving further away from the camera. We are gonna have that skew effect, but then we're just gonna scale it down when it comes to the animation. My image is not the perfect ratio, so what I'm gonna do is crop it. I'm gonna hold Alt, crop the top and crop the bottom, so I can have something like this. Then from there, I'm gonna use the shader filter plugin to give that skew effect. So for it to take the crop into account, I need to put it in a group, which we'll do, and we'll add the filter to the group. So click on filters, plus user defined shader, load shader text from file, and we're gonna find corner pin right there. So the second one, and it will recreate something like this. So top left corner, we're gonna bring that in on the two axes. So top left X and top left Y. Adjust it. We also want bottom left, and it's gonna be bottom left Y. We're gonna pull that in. Then finally top right, we want the X, top right X. Just like that. Then transform it until you're satisfied. What you can also do is add the same cartoon effect to that background. So filters, here's a defined shader. You should probably name those. Load shader text from file, browse, cartoon, open. And then this one, we want more of the hue steps, with basically more color and perhaps more value steps too. All right, so that's pretty much what we're going for. And the next step would be animating it. So let's do that. How do you create animation in OBS Studio? By using the Move plugin, also by Xaldro. In this case, I'm going to collapse those groups, I'm gonna right click on the scene, go to filters, click plus here, and we're gonna find move source. I'm gonna call this one character left. So because my character is gonna go from left to right, under source, we wanna select GTAV cam, which is the group with my picture in it. We're gonna scroll down a little bit and click get position. All right, now we can go back up here. We can duplicate this and call this character right. What we want to do now with that group selected is move your character to the right, but not too much since the whole thing needs to be pretty slow. That's pretty much all it's going to be, except we want character right to take its sweet time. So under custom duration, you can put like 5,000 milliseconds, then scroll down and click get transform. So now if I go ahead and click character left, it should zoom to the left. Okay, and if I click character right, it should take its sweet, sweet time. Nice. There's only one issue, is that it's easing in. So it's accelerating and decelerating. So yeah, it's easing in and it's easing out, and we don't want that. Thankfully, the move source filter gives you the easing option right there. And all we have to do is click no easing. Try it again. There you go. All right, now let's do the animation for the background, and we can still do it here since we're in the scene filters. So add a move source. We're gonna call this one back initial. Make sure source is GTA background group. Click get transform, then duplicate, call back final. Custom duration for this one is going to be 5,000 milliseconds. And remember, no easing. And this time we're gonna select it, and I'm just gonna make it a little smaller. But like barely, and then place it roughly where it was. Okay, from there, now I can scroll down and click get transform. All right, we can test it, back initial and back final. All right, now the move plugin is so good that you can trigger multiple things at once. So I'll say that if car right is initiated at the same time, if I scroll down, simultaneous move should be back final. Same thing for character left, so initial position for the character. I'm gonna set it so that if it's initiated, simultaneous move should be back initial to reset everything. So bloop, reset everything, and bloop, play them together. There you go. That is so cool. Now for the sake of it, I'm gonna add the text that says loading. Okay, we're almost there. We don't have any actual background right now, it's just transparent. So let's add a color source for that. Color source and select black and just drag it down. Nice. Now to make sure that we don't use a bunch of actions in Streamerbot, I wanna set it so that it resets itself automatically. So we know that if I click character right, it's going to trigger the animation. But then I want the next move to be just a reset. So I'm gonna scroll down and I'm gonna click next move, and this should be character left. Since character left triggers back initial, it should basically be automatic now. So character right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and reset. Nice. Now here's the thing. Can we make it so that it triggers automatically when this scene becomes visible? So you can see under action here, character right is going to be our main trigger. And under actions, there's start trigger. Let's look at our options. Here, source activate when the source becomes actively shown in the final mix. We'll select this and we'll test it out right now by adding this to a normal scene. So full screen scene. Hi. We're gonna add a new source that will be a scene, and we're gonna pick GTA 5. Click OK. And as you can see, as soon as it showed up, the animation started. It also resetted itself. To test it one more time, I'm gonna click on the eye, turn it off, turn it back on. It works. Which means that with Streamerbot, all we have to do is basically tell it, hey, turn it on and then turn it off. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna go to show transition or hide transition. So this is where you would pick how it basically comes into screen. I think something like a slide could be good. I just wanna make sure that maybe 600 milliseconds for the custom duration of that slide would be good. We can preview it. I think that's nice. If I turn it off and I turn it back on, I think it fits the theme. Perfect. Now let's pick how we want it to go away. Hide transition. Let's also do a slide, because why not? Except direction, I want it to be right, left. Comes in like this. And we're gonna tell Streamerbot before it resets to just bloop and ta-da. Of course, we're also gonna tell Streamerbot to basically take the picture in a way. So basically trigger the freeze frame right before. So it's dynamic. It's not gonna be the same picture over and over again. It's actually gonna be interactive. Anyways, enough speculating about Streamerbot. Let's launch it and make it happen. So in Streamerbot under actions, you want to right click, click add for a new action. Give it a name. GTA 5 loading. All right. And now sub actions. And we want to think carefully about the order of things. Thankfully, there isn't much really. GTA 5 cam is the group with my camera in it. And basically the default state is going to be unfreeze. So we'll tell Streamerbot now freeze.
Yeah, here comes the man in black.
And then after freezing, we'll tell Streamerbot, hey, turn it on this scene after freezing. Okay, wait about 4,500 milliseconds and then slide it off. That's it. So here, right click, we want OBS, we want sources, we want set source filter state. Our scene is GTA right there. Our source is GTA 5 cam. Our filter is freeze and we want to set it to visible. Boom. And then we want to make it visible in our scene. So we would go OBS, sources, set source visibility state, scene full screen, source GTA 5, and make it visible. And then what happens? It's gonna turn on. You're gonna have the little animation. You want it to wait during that animation. So we're gonna go core, delay, and we said we wanted 4,500, for example, so we don't see the reset. So all we have to do now is reverse it. So I'm gonna right click on this source visibility state for the scene here as a source. I'm gonna right click, go to duplicate sub action, double click, and just pick hidden. So hide it, okay? And also in order to reset the freeze, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna duplicate that. It's gonna appear at the bottom, double click, and we're gonna make that hidden. And just like that, you have your little GTA stuff. You can go ahead and download maybe a custom sound, custom music to play during this whole thing. You can pick whatever you want as a trigger. It could be a chat command, it could be alerts, it could be subs, bits, follows, anything. But for now, we're gonna do a channel point reward. So I'm gonna right click under triggers, Twitch, channel reward, reward redemption, create reward, and this will be GTA 5 loading screen. Write your description, set the cost, and click OK. Click OK again. So now we can test it. I can bring this down here. And I can right click, test trigger. I forgot to unfreeze. Let's do that again. So now we can test it. Right click, test trigger. That was kind of weird, so let's do it again. All right, so I'm noticing that maybe we need to give the background removal a little bit of time. So we can add a delay between when it freezes and when it becomes visible. Just a small, small delay. So core delay, let's say 50 milliseconds. And don't forget to drag it up. There you go. Now we can test it. Right click, test trigger. There you go, way better. Right, we can also see that it resets a little faster than anticipated, so we can just set the delay here for 4,000 milliseconds. Test it again. It's still fast. Maybe let's adjust the filter. Character right. Let's put it to 600 milliseconds. We'll also put back final to the same. This should be good. Nice. Of course, you want to spend more time on this. Maybe put your own little logo to the left here. Put your own music, put some GTA music. I don't know. I gave you the idea. You do the rest. Hey, we just created this. Let's say that you're live streaming and this is your just chatting scene. And someone goes and redeems your brand new GTA 5 loading screen effect. And they click redeem. All right, honestly, after testing it for multiple times, I realized that, I don't know, the freeze frame plus the background removal doesn't work all that well all the time. I don't know, the mask around it seems to be weird. I even bumped up, you see that? It seems to like not update in time and it freezes in the wrong position or something. But I also realized that, hey, you don't even have to freeze frame technically. You could just do this. You could just do this. So you can go ahead and remove the freeze frame if you just want to have the effect while, you know, you're still animated like this. If I turn it on right now, you know, at least this way it works better. You still get the animation, you still slide left to right. All right, anyways, that was the concept. I hope you enjoyed, but go ahead, play around with it. If you manage to recreate it, post it on Twitter, tag me. I love seeing what you guys come up with. And I'll see you next time. Get level out.